Having an idea of how a typical mechanical watch functions will help you with the assembly process. Depending on whether your watch has a screw-down crown, you may have to first unscrew the crown. Your crown can be in three or two positions depending on whether you have a movement with a date function. Pushed all the way in, the movement is at its winding position. This is where you can wind up the movement. Winding it around 20 to 40 times will give it a full power reserve and it should last at least 40 hours. Pull the crown all the way out, you'll be at the time setting position. Newer Miyota and Seiko movements have a hacking function, which stops the second hand when you set time. This will allow you to set the time more precisely. If your movement has a date function, there will be another click in between the time setting and winding position. This is the date setting position. Make sure you don't set the date plus or minus 4 hours from midnight, or you risk damaging the movement. If my watch hasn't been worn for a while, or if I'm not sure whether the watch is at 10 a.m. or 10 p.m. in this case, I'd set the time forward to make sure. The date didn't transition, so this should be around noon instead of around midnight. In this case, I can proceed to adjust the date. Here's another example. Let's say I'm not sure if this is at 8 a.m. or 8 p.m. on the watch, so I set the time forward towards midnight. The date starts to transition, so I set the time forward until it's past 4 a.m. Now I can set the date. For movements without watch hands installed, I'd suggest not adjusting the date at all unless you know how to tell if the date mechanism is engaged. This large rotating component at the back is our rotor. This is what winds up the watch for us as we move around. Some of us have the habit of taking the watch off while working, or have a lifestyle in which we don't move our wrists much. This may result in the watch not winding sufficiently through our wrist movements. So if you notice that your watch occasionally stops, you may want to manually wind it when you wear the watch in the morning. I have a habit of giving it a few winds and setting the time before I leave in the morning, as then I don't need to worry about the watch stopping or having an accuracy deviation of more than 15 seconds within the day. For watches with a screw-down crown, remember to screw the crown back in so your watch is waterproof.